Yes.
So, well, today we're going to go and start our second workshop. Welcome. Welcome to our class. Pablito and Romy are in the same house and they will be working together today. Miguel, thank you for being here. And well, let me show you here some pictures. All right, I'm going to use this link in Activity A and show you these pictures here. All right. So, what is that? What place is it? Is it a house?
So-so.
Oh, it's a house, is it? Or a type of house? What is that, Pablito? Answer, tell me. Or is that a house or an apartment? No?
A house.
This is a special type of house because my house is not like this. Is your house like that, Miguel?
No.
No, right?
No.
No. And what kind of place is that? That's a castle. Castle. Repeat, please. Castle.
Castle.
Uh-huh. Romy, repeat. Castle. Castle.
Castle.
Ah, exactly, a castle. This one here is a castle. Who lives in a castle?
Príncipes, reyes.
Aha, princes and kings. Kings. Let me write the word here in the chat box. So, a king. A king lives in a castle. And today I'm going to tell you the story about a king. So pay a lot of attention. Okay? Now, the king lives in a castle. Is the king someone important or not important?
Very important.
Mm-hmm.
Important.
Exactly. A king is an important person. And in this story, the king has a problem. Look at the king in this picture. Is he old or young?
Old.
Mm-hmm. The king is old. And look at him. Is he happy?
No, he's serious.
Why do you think he's serious?
Está triste y está serio.
Oh. He's sad. Why? What's the problem?
Tal vez.
Imagine.
Algún problema económico, financiero. Sería.
All right. It might be a money problems or economical problems. All right. More ideas. Why do you think he's worried? He's an old king. What happens to old people? Are old people strong and healthy? Tell me, what do you think his problem is? What about the future? Do you think he's happy about the future? Tell me, is the king happy? Romina, is the king happy? No. No, why not? Does the king have any problem? How old is the king? Look at the king. How old is he? What do you think? How old is the king? Say it, come on. Is he 15 years old like Pablito?
Seventeen-eight.
Say it again.
17-8.
No, 17, more. How old is the king?
89.
More.
90.
90. Aha. Uh-huh. So the king is worried about the future. Right? He's worried about the future because he's 90. And in few years, what do you think it will happen? Do you think he will live forever? Will the king be king for more years? No, right? This is an old king. And his territory needs a new king. Who are these children? Who are they? Listen to me. Who are they? Are they the king's friends? Who are these children? Are they the king's friends?
Children.
Okay, probably. Teenagers. Uh-huh. And what happens to them? Why do you think the emperor, the king, wants to see them? What is the relationship with the king?
Good relation.
Okay. Who do you think is good for king, for the future king? The girl? The big boy? The king wants a future king. The king wants a new king. All right? So the king is looking for one child to become the new king. Okay? What is this? What is this? What is this thing? You can tell me in Spanish, no problem. But tell me, what is that?
Semilla.
Mm-hmm, correct. This is a seed.
Yes.
It's a seed. Uh-huh. A seed. Uh-huh. And how do you use a seed? What do you do? Do you play with seeds? Remember, you can answer to me in Spanish if you understand the question. No, you don't play with seeds. What Do you eat seeds?
Yes.
What do you do with a seed? Miguel?
No. No, por.
Pablo, say it again.
No, porque las semillas se les planta pues para que crezcan nuevas plantas y no es para.
Ah, all right. Ajá, very good. So you plant. You plant the seed. And what happens when you plant the seed? What else do you do, Pablito? Continue, continue. You're doing well. What other things do you put in the seed?
En la tierra.
Ajá.
En la tierra. And luego ponemos agua y con el sol siguen creciendo poco a poco.
Exactly. So in English, you can say that you nurture the seed. Nurture.
Nurture.
So if you nurture the seed, you put water and the seed grows beautiful, right? Now, in the story that I mentioned, do you remember the story? What happened in the first part of the story? We saw a... What did you see first, in the first picture? What was in the first picture? No, there was not a seed in the first picture. We have a... What's this? No, what's this? Romy?
Palace.
Yes, a palace or a castle.
Castle.
Castle. Castle. All right. So in this story, there is a castle. Who lives in the castle? Who lives in the castle?
Kings.
A king. A young kid? Young king or an old king?
Old king.
Yes, there is an old king. And the old king is happy or sad about the future?
Sad.
Sad.
Aha, he's worried about the future. Why is he worried about the future? What does he need? Does the king want another castle? What is the problem with the king? He needs a...
Se le murió la esposa, la reina.
No, not really. But what happens to an old person? This is an old person. Very old, 100 years old, 90 years old. What do you think he's thinking about? Is he going to live more?
Está preocupado porque puede ser que no, que quiere dejar buena descendencia, pero no sabe con cuál.
Exactly. That is the problem. Uh-huh. So he needs a new emperor. He wants a new king. And he wants to choose one good king. All right? Very good, Miguel. He wants a new king. Now, suppose that you are kings. How do you choose? What are the qualities of a good king? What are some positive things about a good king?
Tell me. He's a good king. Uh-huh. More.
Intelligent.
Intelligent. Uh-huh. Another word. Experience. That's a uh-huh. Good. So this intelligent king wants a new king. And what do you think the king do? Imagine what happened in the story.
Que podría ser que el rey les mandó a los hijos a las semillas, como el cuentito que a nosotros nos decían de pequeños, y la semilla que crecía más se llevaba la herencia.
Very good. Exactly. So the king gives the children a seed.
Ah, ya sé. Cuando mandó a la semilla que planten y el que mejor le cuide es el que mejor tendrá el castillo o el que mejor va a mantener las condiciones para liderar el castillo.
Is that your prediction? Okay, very good. Sounds smart. Sounds logical. So, who do you think will become the next emperor? Look at his word when he steps down, when he finishes being the king. Miguel, what is your prediction? Who will succeed the emperor?
Is the
who will be the new king?
The three person, la tercera persona.
I don't know, but you said that the person who is careful with the seed, who plants a nice seed. Okay, so that's your prediction. Let's check. I'm going to stop sharing this and I'm going to go back to our handout. Now let's play a game, okay? Okay. Miguel, Romy, Pablito, write your answers in the chat box, okay? Use the chat box and let's find out some important words. Okay, let's wait here. Please put the word, the letters in order and give me the correct answer, all right? Let's see. Okay, so let's start. So look at his face. What is the first letter? What is the first letter? Here with me, what is the first letter? With me, not individually, here with me. Letter is first. What letter is first?
Yes.
Yes, okay. Second letter.
E.
Second letter, go ahead. E.
H.
No.
H.
Then? What letter is next after C? We have S, H, O, C. The next letter. The next letter.
La K.
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 K. Perfect. Shocked. Repeat, shocked. Okay, let's see this word. What letter is first?
A.
A. No. Another one. What letter is first?
G.
Tommy. G. No. More letters. Romy, you can participate too. Fast, 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 fast. Don't think too much.
Turn the micro. Está apagado.
Pablito, what letter is first?
A.
Hurry. A is not first. What letter is this? Or E? E.
L.
L. No. Hurry. Faster, faster. Go ahead. Which one? T. No. Look at the boy.
Sí.
Sí. Aha, good, Romy, excellent. Another letter, second letter.
R.
No. Second letter.
E.
Yes, very good. Letter number three.
G.
Hurry up, the time is about to be up. More letters.
L.
L. Good.
E.
T. What is the word?
Celebrating.
Celebrating. Celebrating. Celebrating. Good. What is the second letter? Second word. First letter.
E.
Correct. Second.
X.
Aha.
T.
Letter number three. Correct.
E.
E. Not E. What's the next letter?
E.
E. E. This one is E. Or I.
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 Aha, the next one. Look at the boy. What is the boy doing? Celebrating, celebrating.
E.
The next one, hurry. E. This one is E.
E.
Say it. Sorry?
E.
Aha. The next one.
D. D. D.
Celebrating excitedly. Celebrating excitedly. Look at the boy in the picture. What about this one? First letter.
M.
No. Next. Say it again.
A.
Louder. A. There is no A here.
E.
E. E. Mm-hmm. Look at the picture. What's that? T. Yeah, it's empty, empty, nothing there, empty, empty what? Second. Hurry, B. Empty.
B.
Letter.
B.
Second.
Oh.
Empty pot. This is an empty pot. An empty pot. Okay, look at his voice. Look at his face, letter one.
Hey.
Hurry, hey. Good, good.
Hey.
The next one. Perfect. Who's next? Z. Z. Amazed. Look at the boy. The boy is amazed. Excellent. Look at this kid. Look at his face.
H.
Aha. Not H. Look at him, his face. Ha ha ha. What's he doing? Hey. Good. The next one.
You.
Aha. Laugh. 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 Oh, look at this person. What is this person doing?
Hey.
Aha. Next.
I.
Hide. The person is hiding. Hide in the sofa, hiding. Oh, what happened? Look at the this student. Not good, right? First yes. Letter. Mm-hmm. Second letter.
A.
Mm-hmm, good. Next.
Oh.
Aha. L, no.
R.
R. R. No R.
I.
Fail. Fail. R. R. Failure. Failure. Yeah, she feels she's a failure. So let's take a look at the words. So look at number one. The boy is shocked. Shocked.
Shocked.
Shocked. Huh. When a person is shocked, is it a good surprise or a bad surprise? What do you think? Is it positive or negative to be shocked?
Positive.
No, it's negative. Yes, bad. I saw an accident and I am shocked. Shocked after the accident. Shocked. Okay? Repeat. The kid is shocked. The kid is shocked.
He was shocked.
Mm-hmm. In the second picture, remember? Celebrating. Celebrating excitedly.
Celebrating.
Celebrating, exactly. Is it very happy or very sad?
Happy. Very.
Aha, exactly. Empty pot. Empty pot. Yes. Pablito, what can I put in an empty pot? Can I put a plant in an empty pot?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Can I plant a seed in an empty pot?
Flowers.
Flowers, of course. I can plant a seed and have flowers. Great. Amazed. Amazed. Is it positive or negative to feel amazed?
Positive.
Yes. Aha, uh-huh, good. And laugh. Is the person very happy or very sad?
Very happy.
Correct. Hide, like me this moment. I'm hiding. Can you see me? No, can you see me?
No,
because I am hiding. I am hiding, all right? To hide. And failure. If a person is a failure, is the person happy? When a person feels a failure, is it good or bad? When a person says, oh, bad, yeah. I have a bad grade in my exam and I feel like a failure. I feel bad. Okay. So, let's check the next activity. Okay, look at the girl in this picture. Okay, let's complete the sentences with the new words. All the kids were and making fun of me when I failed the goal. Look at the picture. What's the girl doing? All the kids were empty pot. Is empty pot the word?
No,
all the kids were
celebrating
and making fun of me. All the girls were
happy
and making fun of me. Okay, let's write happy and let's see. But happy is not a word. It's not a word in the new vocabulary.
Aye.
Only the words in the new vocabulary. What word? All the kids were? Look at the picture. De las palabras que vimos. Sí, de esas necesito que pensemos para completar las oraciones.
Fabi, podría ser que los chicos que estaban festejando porque eran del otro equipo y no metieron gol. Estaban burlándose de que no metió gol.
It's not when I fail. It's not about soccer. A goal in English is something that you want to do. For example, I want to do a good mathematics exam. I fail the exam, I fail the goal. Okay? So that in English is something you want to do. That's a goal. So all the kids were, when I failed the goal, or when I can say that when I failed the exam, for example, look.
No.
Oh, laugh. But where? Laughing. Laughing. Okay, laughing. Repeat, please. Laughing.
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 Okay. The second one, look. My girlfriend told me the story about her family trip. My girlfriend is the girl happy or sad?
Happy.
Very happy. What word is for very happy? Like the boy was celebrating.
Celebrating.
Celebrating. Celebrating, very happy. What is very happy? What is the other word for very happy?
Exciting.
Nice, exactly, exactly. My girlfriend excitedly told me the story. Here, look at the sentence, look at the picture.
Kite.
Okay. Look at the picture. I lost the game, Aima. What other words do you have? Okay, Milo. Let's skip that one. The next one. Romy?
Milo.
Very good. Okay, let's see the next one. Put your on the floor.
Safe.
What's this? Look at the picture. What's that in the picture?
Empty pot.
Oh, but this is an empty. Empty pot. When I visited the London Zoo, I was amazed. Okay, let's check your answers. Here. Correct. My gay friend. Second one. Aha. Excitedly. Number three. Let's see.
Kite.
Perfect. And here the answer is failure. Very good. Here, empty pot. Yeah. Now, is this pot empty? There is no plant, right? And when I visited the zoo, I was correct. Very good. Now let's move on to the second part. So, do you remember the story? Can you tell me the story again? There was a... What is the story about? Who remembers? ¿De qué se trataba la historia?
De que Rui estaba triste porque no sabía quién dejar sus herencias, así que le dijo a sus hijos que hagan un saque plan.
Okay, good. So now we're going to make a prediction. Okay, why did the emperor choose Ling as the new emperor? Okay, we're going to read the story now. Okay. Vamos a leer la historia. Pero antes de leer la historia, ¿qué hicimos la vez pasada, el workshop pasado? ¿Se acuerdan? ¿Qué hicimos antes de leer? ¿Pablito?
Sacamos las principales, leyendo rápido.
Pero antes de leer, ¿qué fue lo que hicimos? ¿Se acuerdan?
Era rápida.
Antes de leer, ¿qué hicimos?
Darnos cómo sería la historia. Antes.
Tratar de adivinar. Uh-huh.
Exacto, eso se llama... hacer predicciones. Voy a hacer una predicción sobre la historia. ¿Ok? Make predictions about the story. So, in this story, we're going to make a prediction. I'm going to show you the poll on Zoom. Please make your prediction. Why did the emperor choose Ling as the new king? Why did the old emperor choose Ling as the new emperor? Pablito, Romien, Miguel, vote on Zoom and tell me your predictions. Okay, one more. Okay, perfect. I'm going to show you the results. So your prediction is that Ling was the emperor's son. We're going to see that, okay? Ahora vamos a comprobar si esa predicción es realmente lo que pasa en la historia. Okay, les voy a dar un tiempo para que lean la historia, pero ¿cómo se lee la historia?
Bien, primero, rápido.
Rápido, ¿sí? Solo para revisar si mi predicción fue correcta. Acuérdese qué predicción hicieron. You're telling me that Ling is the emperor's son. ¿Ok? Entonces, vamos a tomarnos... cinco minutos para leer la historia.
¿Puedo apagar el micrófono, Fabi?
Sí. Gracias. So now that you made your prediction, let's check. Very quickly.
Is B.
Está el micrófono apagado.
Sorry, thank you. So very good. You voted now. Let's move on to the next part. You're going to read the story again and use the link, and you're going to answer the questions here. All right? Vamos a leer nuevamente más despacito y ahora vamos ya a contestar las preguntas. Esa es para mí su evaluación de la historia.
Ya.
Cuando falte un minuto, dos minutos, yo les aviso. ¿Ok? Primero lean las preguntas y luego leen la historia y las contestan.
Fabi, ¿puede ir al baño, por favor? Thank you. Thank you, Bobby.
Two more minutes. We have two more minutes. PJ, okay, Isabelita. Okay, guys, very good. Excellent. You had 6/7. So what question was the most difficult here? I'm going to send this to your emails. Great work. Congratulations, excellent. So just let me send this to your emails. What happened here? Okay, there you have. Well, I'll send it later. Excellent. You got very good grades. Now, let's go back here. And the next question is your opinions. Okay, please turn the microphone on. No matter if you tell me in Spanish, but what is the message of this story? What do you think is the message? What is the moral?
In my opinion, is the honest is the value more important para nuestra sociedad. Eso sería.
For society. Very good. Very good. Pablito, what is the message of this story?
Le voy a decir en español ya.
No, it's okay. It's
la vida siempre. Que la vida siempre nos da obstáculos, nos pone retos y nosotros tenemos que sobrellevarlos, pero siempre uh-huh. diciendo la verdad, ya que en este caso las otras personas, porque fueron deshonestas, no se llevaron el gran premio, que en este caso sería toda la herencia del rey, y fue el más honesto y el uh-huh. más humilde.
Beautiful. I love that. Romy, what is your opinion about the message of this story?
Habla que Link fue honesto y por eso ganó lo que tenía que ganar, el premio. Y mostraba uh-huh. lo que demás fueron deshonestos y no pudieron ganar. Y que ser honestos en la vida Very y no good. Hacer las cosas malas.
Beautiful. I love your messages. It's important to be honest. That's the future of society. We need leaders. We need kings. We need authorities who are honest. Very good. Now, I want you to share your opinions, but this time you're not speaking, writing, okay? In activity D, there is a link, and there are two questions. Did you like the story? Why? What did you like about the story? And how can we use this story in our own lives? Pueden escribirlo en español, no importa, ¿sí? Pero quiero que me contesten esas dos preguntas. Okay, did you like this? Lo que me dijeron en este momento, ¿sí? Pero lo van a escribir, ¿ok? So let's use the link and it's gonna be here. So I want to see your answers.
Fabi, ¿puede repetir, porfa, que era lo que teníamos que hacer?
Oh, sure. The same opinion that you gave me about the story. All right. This time, write it. Okay. Write your opinion about the story. Did you like the story, Pablito? No, pasa. Did you like the story?
Profe, a mí me sale que tengo que pedir un código, dice. Por favor, ingresa.
Oh, the code is here, look.
Mande.
The code is on the screen.
Ya, gracias.
That's the code. Mm-hmm.
Todo con mayúscula, ¿verdad?
Ajá, exactly the same code.
En student.
Ajá.
Ya.
¿Todos ya copiaron el código? Romy, ¿ya copiaste el código también?
Ese directo.
Ok, perfecto, chévere. Pablito, ¿el código ya copiamos? Entonces recuerden, la misma opinión. La misma opinión que me dieron hace un momento, ahora quiero que la escriban, ¿ok? Ok, so here we are. Thank you, Pablito. Thank you, Miguel. All right. Correct, Miguel. I agree with you. It's important to be respectful, to be humble. Honesty is very important in society. I agree with you, Romy. Honesty, that link show is what's right, okay? You must always be honest. And Pablito, yes, you're right. In society, honesty is definitely important. All right? So, entonces, el día de hoy, para la lectura, ¿qué fue lo primero que hicimos? ¿Se acuerdan?
Adivinar, ¿cómo se llama? Adivinar.
Hacer una predicción.
Hicimos predicciones, muy bien. ¿Qué más hicimos? Antes de las predicciones, ¿qué les mostré? ¿Se acuerdan?
Imágenes para saber de qué más o menos se trata el tema.
Perfecto. Entonces, muchas veces ustedes se van a encontrar que cuando lean, a veces los textos traen imágenes. Entonces, siempre mirar las imágenes en los textos me ayuda a mí a tener una idea de qué es lo que voy a leer. Y de esa manera yo me creo. Imagínense, antes de leer la historia, ustedes primero usaron su imaginación para decir, ok, la historia puede ser acerca de esto. Pero no la leyeron, sino que usaron las fotografías que yo les mostré. Así que cuando lean un libro, cuando lean un texto, si ese texto tiene una imagen, hay que utilizar las imágenes también para tener una idea de qué es lo que vamos a leer. ¿Qué más miramos? ¿Qué más otra actividad hicimos?
Leer rápido para ya tener la información.
Es siempre importante. Se dan cuenta que al igual que el taller anterior, volvimos a utilizar esa estrategia que se llama skimming. Voy a leer rápido para tener una idea de qué se trata el texto. Pero también hicimos algo importante antes de leer. ¿Qué hicimos? ¿Recuerdan? Vimos
vocabulario.
Ajá, ¿y por qué será esto importante, Pablito? Ver primero el vocabulario antes de leer. ¿Por qué será importante? ¿Por qué crees que primero les mostré el vocabulario?
Porque son palabras clave dentro de la lectura.
Ah, ya, muy bien. Entonces, cuando ustedes vayan a leer un texto, si ven palabras, una, dos palabras, un grupo de palabras que pueden ser claves, no todas, pero sí las palabras claves, entonces puedo usar mi diccionario para buscar de qué se tratan esas palabras únicamente e intentar leer lo demás en inglés para poder así entender. Entonces, miren que en el taller número uno aprendimos a hacer predicciones, aprendimos a leer rápido, después a leer una segunda vez un poco más despacio para poder entender y encontrar detalles. El día de hoy hemos aprendido que es importante mirar las imágenes para darme una historia, una idea de qué es lo que voy a leer, que es importante el vocabulario. Y por eso cuando yo estoy en clases con mi profesor y me manda a estudiar vocabulario, el vocabulario me va a ayudar. Pero también cuando ustedes estén solos y tengan que leer algo en inglés, ustedes tienen que buscar cuál es el vocabulario que me va a servir y quiero aprender. Okay? So, thank you very much for today. I'm going to stop here. Ah, sorry. I'm going to... give you... so, for your participation, I'm going to give everybody points. Class Dojo. So, you were participating. You were doing a good job. Entonces, acuérdense. Ahora tienen 19 puntos. Faltan todavía dos talleres más. La idea es que tratemos de llegar a los 50 puntos. Si llegamos a los 50 puntos, hay un premio para todos ustedes. Miren que no son 50 puntos individuales, sino 50 puntos en grupo. Y les prometo que les voy a hacer llegar una sorpresa, un regalo, si es que ustedes llegan a los 50 puntos. Para el taller número 3, ya van a empezar a ganar puntos individualmente. ¿Sí? Y para eso tienen que tratar de estudiar del material que yo les voy entregando. Lean de nuevo las historias, ¿sí? Dense un tiempito para leer más a conciencia. Si es que en la próxima clase les voy a preguntar sobre qué hicimos en los talleres 1 y 2. Y de acuerdo a eso, ustedes se van a ir ganando los puntos. Y obviamente, de acuerdo a eso, van ustedes a ir teniendo la posibilidad de acumular los 50 puntos. ¿Ok? So, once again, thank you very much for being here, for your time, for your cooperation, your hard work, and have a great afternoon, and see you next time. Okay? Bye-bye. Miguel, bye, Romy, bye, Pablito. Bye. See you in the next workshop. Bye-bye. Merry Christmas. Merry Christmas.